I think that the fall semester is going really well so far. We have a smaller team this year just due to a lot of girls graduating, and we have one that just got deployed. And so that's been a challenge for us to overcome. But in the face of not being able to compete as much last year because of the COVID restrictions, our girls are really rising to the occasion of having that tangible goal in front of them. And so I think that they're doing really well this semester.
This season is a lot about improvement and finding our strengths and weaknesses, and I think it's very helpful to learn what we can improve on, and that's what we've been focusing on a lot, and a lot of heart and just being able to wrestle in tournaments has given us the chance to assess.
It's my first semester here at Liberty, so I was really wanting to get involved in like activities outside of school, and so at CFAW I met Becca. It's really been a big blessing to be able to wrestle this semester, and it's been really fun.
The Liberty women's wrestling team have had a strong start to the new year. After not competing last season, the Lady Flames young roster has already gained valuable experience on the mat through competition.
It's just really nice to see how we started out and then how we are now, and just in that short amount of time, how much we have grown and how much better we've gotten. And there's still room for improvement, but we have a really good team, and it's awesome to see the growth that we've had in just a short amount of time.
As a team, it's just phenomenal to see the number of matches that the girls will get leading up to nationals than in the past we've ever gotten before. So, you know, some of our girls going into Christmas break have 15 matches under their belt. You know, when me and Coach Kendall were on the team, we'd be stoked if we got 10 matches in a whole season. So it's just awesome for them to be able to get this huge of a number of matches in, especially in comparison to not having those last year with COVID. So every match makes them better. Just even if they're losing, it's the experience helps them to know this is what I don't want to happen again, or what I do want to happen again, and to just influence their training for the future.
And that has given us the physical experience of meeting with these other girls who have different styles and learning how to wrestle our own way in that, and being given all these matches as compared to last year has like grown us personally and physically, and I'm excited to see where it goes.
With the fall semester ending, the wrestlers head into their winter break looking to stay disciplined, so when they return for the spring semester, they can pick up where they left off and prepare for the spring season that will feature two national championship events.
Christmas break is always a bit of a challenge because there's a delicate balance between getting a break, kind of letting your body recuperate a little bit, but also not losing focus on what's ahead and keeping your eyes on the prize. And we always tell them it's like parallel to our walk of faith. We don't always have someone over us telling us, like, are you seeking the Lord every day? And that's a discipline. And so, like, in the same way, we're asking the girls to rise up and have discipline over this break. And I think it's going to show a lot of maturity and help them to really take initiative for their own success in the sport.
We've just really told them it's important that they keep their training up, and when they're gone, you know, we want people to have time with their family, but we're sending them with workouts to do on their own throughout the week, and we're gonna hit the ground running when we get back in January. They'll have about 2 weeks to train, and then we have another event that we're wrestling in, and so I'm just hoping and praying that that they'll continue to train hard when they're gone and they're away with their families, and just keep their focus on what they want in the end.